many of us agree on the central thrust, which is the private market, because there was inadequate regulation from the government, thanks to a conservative philosophy that says the market knows best, the private market, left on its own, engaged in activity, sophisticated financial activity, that did a lot of good and did a lot of harm. And the harm is now outweighing the good in that this market is choked. They have made enough bad decisions and accumulated enough bad assets that they can't get out from under. And the problem here is that they're not the only ones suffering. This is not just Wall Street that's hurting. You're reaching the point now where people won't be able to get loans to buy cars. So the auto workers and the people in the sales rooms that sell cars are hurt. You're getting to the point where people who might want to refinance a house or buy a new home, if they can find one now, the prices are low, but they can't get a loan. You're going to have small businesses not being able to finance the inventory. So this threatens our ability as an economy to function. Given that, and we wish we weren't here, I agree with the position of Bernanke and Paulson that we need to have the federal government step in. Our hope is this, that there are, not our hope, our recognition is there are assets out there that are owned by private companies that are almost certainly worth more than you could get today because there's not anybody who's got the ability or the willingness to buy them. If the federal government steps in, we can do some bargain hunting. We can buy and hold these assets for a couple of years. It is a $700 billion or maybe a $400 or $500 billion outlay at first, but it won't cost us that ultimately. We will buy these assets, sell them later. We might even break even. Maybe it'll cost us something, but nothing like this. That's necessary so the economy begins to function again.
Join us online at charlierose.com.